God.
Their souls are plagued by filth. So he cooks them with the flame. Burn! Burn with the light of our Father!
Oh my God.
Sacrifice the weak! Cleanse your soul with God's righteous flame!
Death and that piece of shit deserved.
What is up, guys? Game Tuners here once again with another installation of Far Cry 5. If this is your guys' first time checking out the channel, then please, bottom right-hand corner, give that little subscription button a click so you guys can stay up to date with what is going on with the channel. And with that, let's play Far Cry 5. Right, let's go hit up the first mission of Jacob Seed's area, the Whitetail Mountains, which is the lumber mill mission. So let's go do that. Fuck is everyone? Jesus. Hiding everywhere. It's just annoying. Are they over here?
Hey,
Knight. Where's the other guy? Come on. Okay, I don't know what the fuck just happened right there. That should have been a lot easier, but I don't really know what happened there, but okay, that's fine. It's all good. If I could shoot the actual boxes from a distance, like the alarm boxes, and they'll be covered. There's that one on the roof, though, that I could probably hit. That is one thing I do like about the Far Cry games, though, is if you can play one of their games, then you can play all of them, because they're all really, 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 really similar. All the controls have been the same forever. I mean, my first one was Far Cry 3, and I could literally pick up Far Cry 3 right now. It's almost the same as that game. I mean, obviously not the same as that game, but you know what I mean. Very, 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 very easy gameplay, like, easy controls, stuff like that. Is there only one alarm? God, dude, there's no way you can live from that. Okay, dude can survive being riddled with bullets, but he falls fucking 4 feet, he dies. Oh my god. Oh my god, dude, this is stupid. Fuck you, Jacob. Quit looking at me with those fucking judgmental eyes and your big ass dumbo ears. Get out of here. God, I landed so perfectly. I'm not gonna do it again. So far. because fucking old boy can't handle falling.
Okay, yeah, that probably would kill you, but whatever. The squad. There is our character.
Deputy, I gotta tell you.
Where the hell did you come from?
Some of the whitetails, well, some of them weren't so sure about bringing you on board. They're sure now. Not because of anything I said, but because what you've done. Actions speak louder than words. People are coming from all over to join the Whitetails. You're giving them hope again. That's been a long time coming, Depp. A long time.
Well, thought Jacob would want to say something, but I guess not. Alright.
Need your help. It's important. Thanks for busting me out. Name's Jess. If you're out here picking fights with the cult, then I'm guessing you already know my Uncle Dutch. Look, I don't got a lot of time to waste.
Hey.
I'm gonna get right to the point.
Uncle's Dutch.
I was on the trail of one of Jacob's zealots. Goes by the name The Cook. Yeah, don't sound so scary. But believe me, he's one twisted fuck. Almost tracked him down. But a Peggy patrol got the drop on me. I need your help. We can't let this trail go cold. This guy's butchered a lot of innocent folk around here. Can't let him get away with it any longer. Gotta move. Wasted too much time already. Follow me. This way.
You're not gonna take the truck? You're gonna walk there, all right.
See that? That's his calling card. Innocent people burned alive.
Oh. Go faster.
Cult grabbing everyone. They'll take you from your home.
You literally can walk
bar,
faster than you can.
Church. Don't matter where you are. Then they slot you into one of two categories, weak or strong. See, Jacob's building an army, and anyone who can't or won't fight for it winds up dead. Culling the herd, he calls it. Wholesale slaughter innocent people.
Nice.
Nobody believed it was happening, because nobody wanted to believe.
Oh my god, Jess, you're so fucking slow. Dude, why are you acting like you're jogging or something? You ain't going fast. Yeah, I see them. Oh. Alright, she don't play games.
He deserves.
Jesus. Pile of burnt bodies.
can't.
Sucks. I can help.
You really this sucks. Bad out of the
fire. I love that guy.
There's more of us.
There's a lot more of them out there, Devil. Up the mountain. If you come across any others, you rescue them, too. Don't let those goddamn Peggy's take any more good folk.
Took them up the mountain. Hey, hostages. Bust him out of the cage.
Help us get away from here.
My light flashed from my eyes there.
But there were others. They took them up the mountain.
Okay, let's get moving. You want to know why they call him the cook? A couple years back, Jacob sent one of his guys out to round up his family. Parents and kids. First thing he did was starve them. Gave them nothing. Not even a drop of water. After 3 days, they got so thirsty they had to drink their own piss. But the kids didn't want to do it. So the parents forced it down their throats. The kids puked it right back up. The cook didn't like that. He went and strung the parents up on posts under the hot sun.
Jesus Christ, what's wrong with people?
Hold up. I think I heard something.
You think you heard that gunshot in the distance? Oh, really?
All the work you've
this
been
guy's
doing
got the fucking use of a bat. Look out.
Stock up on new supplies. Check out the shop if you get a chance.
Point. I got your back. Remember, if they spot us, those people are dead on sight.
There's one. I guess that was loud. Oh my god, dude, quit crying. Jesus. He's still crying. Let's go then.
Let's go.
Oh, gee, he's got to be behind fucking
who have you lost?
Jogging Jess. No wonder she lost the damn trail. She fucking was walking there.
So the cook. Yeah, the parents on posts and decided to give the kids a little water. And then he asked if they were hungry. The kids were starving, so they said yes. Started begging for food. Cook asked if they want pork.
Oh, he fed on their parents.
So he went out to the parents and took their shoes off and started to play. This little piggy went to market. And the blood poured like a damn faucet. Cook had a big old grin on his face as he offered each little piece to the kids. Piggies left. So he laughed and set the parents on fire. And stopped screaming. I looked around. He was just gone. Vanished like some sort of demon in the night. Anyways, that's why they call him the cook.
What the fuck is wrong with people? God.
Their souls are plagued by filth. So he cooks them with the flame. Burn! Burn with the light of our father!
Oh my God.
Sacrifice the weak! Cleanse your soul with God's righteous flame!
Better death than that piece of shit deserved. Hey man, you look how I feel.
Yep.
Thought I'd be happy.
I'm assuming that was her husband.
That's it, I guess. Dutch was right. Cook's dead, and I don't feel anything. All I ever wanted was to find this guy. And now, I don't know what I'm supposed to do.
Work for me, dude.
Dutch has been right about a lot of shit lately. Colt, Eli, maybe he's right about you too. You need someone to watch your back? Call me. And, thanks for everything you've done.
Kind of pissed me off that I wasn't able to save this poor dude.
Human brain is a fascinating thing. Once you start poking around in there, it's surprising what you get it to do under the right circumstances. You're familiar with the term classical conditioning, right, Deputy? It's where a conditioned stimulus, say a song, leads to a reflective response. In this case, to train. To kill. To sacrifice.
My God, dude. This game is getting more and more gruesome as you get deeper into it. Jacob Seed. What do you gotta say this time, my guy? Let's get my cage. Oh!
must be hungry. Yeah. Did you know it takes 10 days for civilization to collapse?
Yeah. You take away a man's basic needs, and he will revert to his primordial instincts in just 10 days. That's a difficult thing to understand unless you've lived it.
How is he not slitting his throat?
You know, I was in Iraq during the first Gulf War. 82nd Airborne All-Americans. Hoorah!
Yeah, he's
burned. One night there was an ambush. And me and this guy named Miller got separated from the unit. No food. No radio. Nearest base, 200 clicks to the south, so we just started walking. Well, by the third day, I knew we were lost. Day six, ran out of water. You know what that's like, don't you? Difficult to swallow. On the seventh day, Miller's legs started going all wonky. Did you know your brain starts to eat your muscles in order to survive? That's why you're so goddamn skinny. And by the eighth day, the wolves were closing in. And I looked at Miller and I could tell we were as good as dead. And I accepted that. And in that acceptance came clarity.
Oh god, he killed him
you
too.
You see, I wasn't just looking at Miller. I was looking at an opportunity. It wasn't something I wanted. It was something that I had to do. It was my test. You see, Miller's sacrifice wasn't about me walking out of that desert. It was about bringing me here. The weak have their purpose. You'll understand that soon enough.
Killed his buddy too.
Sacrifice the weak.
Make no sacrifice!
Call the weak!
I got the aim with this fucking thing. It's a one-hit kill anyway.
Good. Not bad.
Perfect. Cause the other I guess the other deputy was a guy who was flying the helicopter. I don't really care about him, no offense.
Starts again. Follow me.
It starts again.
Got it all planned out. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. Then he's got you. It becomes second nature, routine. He gets in your head. And you don't even realize it. You can't ever go back. You understand?
Why is his head shaking so much?
You can't ever go back. Come on. Truck. My truck's gotta be there. Gotta get on the truck. It's almost time. I've studied the route for weeks. It's the only way out. You'll be safe if you don't.
So he conditions people to, like, faint it at that song, pretty much.
Where the Grill Streak used to be. They've got something up on the screen there you've got to see.